you know, Katie, one thing that you may want to think about is that a lot of people in the medical world have to take tests, board certifications, nursing tests, exams, everything else. And right now, my physicians in mid-levels have to, if they're successful to match, they have to go down to Duluth to the North Shore Bank building across from Menards and sit and have their board certification proctored to them, where they get online and you go in there with your clear plastic bag and your pencil and whatever else you may need. So that might be something to look at in terms of a testing facility in this. Where's Amy? I'm thinking in the launch pad somewhere near Main Street, maybe in a lower level.
Who's to say?
That could be one of those testing facilities for Northern Minnesota, because I've had physicians that needed to sit for their boards. Duluth has been filled, and then they would have to fly to Chicago to take their board certification.
Oh my gosh.
So that may be something as you go through. I've also had certified medical assistants that have to take their online tests, that have to go to a testing facility. So that might be another offshoot for this launch pad.
That's a really good idea.
Same goes for other types of certifications too. Like, I know my sister, who's an accountant, in order to take her series of tests, had to drive how many times to get those. I don't know what process you need to get tested. I know through the college too, there's a number of courses that they have to go down to the WGO company in order to get certified.
Getting would think the city administrator would have told me about that.
In government, we like to keep our don't share too much. It's dangerous.
Especially with the driver.
Alright. Anyway, with the pocket park, we just sent out an RFP and the question period just closed to making that a hot spot. So when people come to enjoy the park, they can also be online. We don't know right now if there's going to be a data cap there or a cap to the number of people who can log on. We're kind of just leaving that up to when we get the proposals back just to see what works. But that will be one of the places where when you log on to the Wi-Fi, that splash page, that community portal pops up. I mean, my personal opinion, I wouldn't want to limit someone going there and, you know, watching a video or doing something. So I prefer a higher limit on that. And now we are making our way to the high school.
Yeah, so I'm going to drive my car right on the runway.
Perfect.
That's the turn.
Can we hear a little more about the pocket park? What's the vision for that? What's a pocket park?
$75,000 of matching funds. So they have basically given the lot after they purchased it to the city to include in our park registry. And then the city has put in, and will be putting additional in-kind services to help them with renovations and some of the other things. So the energy that this group has, which is basically made up of mostly millennials and Gen Xers, which I'm a Gen Xer, not a millennial. I think I'm still a Gen Xer. Has been tremendous. So it's nice to see that this youth movement we have within the city is actually answering the challenge to get invested in their communities. So it is very refreshing. I sit on a large foundation for Dr. Ben Owens, and we had just given this group $10,000 grant, which I delivered the other night, to help them continue to further the pocket park and the stuff they're doing, whether it's Kiwanis Park and the planting. But it's really exciting from a city perspective to see the energy that this group brings. So.
All right. So now we're